Let's look at that realistically in the scriptures. How many years was it from Joshua to Solomon? Because the kingdom didn't become great till Solomon. Saul built portion of the kingdom. King David built the portion of the kingdom. Solomon brought it to its greatest height that we've ever taken it to, and failed. What I'm saying is, you're at that initial stage of building the kingdom of your own. What you all have done with the legal portion is so powerful. When the timing is right, when that moment comes, and we have mastered, if when you mastered exactly what you're supposed to know, our nation stands on that foundation. Do you understand what I'm saying? On a physical aspect, I'm saying it stands. All the problems, all the issues, the fighting, this and that, we're going to have those still, but not on the level that we have them today. Because that initial sovereign peace is what it takes in order for you to solidify your nation within the realm of other nations. Like I said, there has to be the spiritual component and a physical component to everything. It's not poof and magic, it's work. It takes planning, all of those things. Continue.
And the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
Okay, I want to end, stop there. Sorry, hold on one second. Now, what is our philosophy? What do we believe? It's important to understand this. We believe in simply doing right.
That's right. Being righteous.
We are not a religion. We utilize that. We understand the power to define, and we understand utilizing that to be able to utilize that in law. But I'm coming outside of that right now. I'm talking about literally. We never have been a religion. One thing that you understand that's so powerful is that the actual scriptures are utilized in their law. You can utilize that as the supreme law. It's the supreme law. But what I want you to get is the Bible, or not, I would say the Torah and Tanakh, they are not, especially the Torah, they are not religious books. Religion was created so he could create other platforms to compete with you to take us out of nationality. You don't say an Israelite and an Ishmaelite and an Adamite and a Frenchman and that. You don't say that. What people say is an Israelite versus the Christians versus the Muslims. Those are religions. We fell into the realm of religion. Oh. Moors pulled you out of that. That's what you were saying earlier. That's why you said we do everything on as Moors when we're dealing with politics. Because that took us out of a religious thought and put us into a nationalistic thought. Israel is a nation of people, not a religion. The scriptures is our constitution with case law. It has regular statutory law. Legislative law is not a religion. So when you come in, so now with that power that you all have and thinking that, don't go in there. They know it's not a religion. Don't go into those courts with the mindset this is a religious book. It's not. These are codified statutes of law that must be respected by all people on earth. Not just, and they know this. But as long as Israel stays down and does not take hold of their Elohimship or El power, They are allowed to be on top and not tell you. You must understand your power. Sleeping. Go to Isaiah 49. Start at the first one.
Reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 49, verse 1. Listen, O owls, unto me, and hearken, ye people, from far. For y'all have called me from the womb, from the bowels of my mother hath he made mention of my name. And he hath made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand has he hid me.
Wow. Continue.
And made me a polished shaft.
He made me a polished shaft. He's polishing you right now. What you're learning right now is so important.
In his quiver has he hid me. And said unto me, thou art my servant, O Israel.
Thou art my servant, O Israel. For what?
In whom I will be glorified.
In whom I will be glorified. Go ahead.
Then I said, I have labored in vain.
Every work that I'm doing has been laboring in vain. I've been going out to work to make money for my wife. I've been doing this. I've been getting a car, house. All my work is in vain.
I have spent my strength for naught.
I've spent my strength for nothing.
In vain.
In vain.
Yet surely my judgment is with y'all.
Yet surely my judgment is with y'all.
And my work with y'all.
No, say it.
And my work with my y'all.
And my work with my Elohim. My work is with my Elohim. The Yahweh, who are you being? Continue.
And now, saith Yah, that formed me from the womb.
And now, saith Yah, that formed me from the womb.
To be his servant. Mm-hmm. To bring Yaakov again to him.
To bring Yaakov back to him again. But watch this.
Though Israel be not gathered, yet shall I be glory in the eyes of Yah. And my Yah shall be my strength. And he said, it is a light thing that thou shalt be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob and to restore the preserved of Israel. I will also give thee for a light to the Gentile.
Now the word Gentiles there is nations. I'm going to give you a light as a light to the nations. So I don't care what nationality you are. When Israel comes, you must listen when the right ones come. Sir, go to the Quran. When the right ones come. Well, that's so. It's very important. Start at 10.
Read it from the Holy Quran.
Okay. Say that again. Read it from what?
Read it from the Holy Quran.
Go ahead.
Surah 3, Ayat 110. Ye are the best of people, evolved for mankind, enjoining what is right, forbidding what is wrong, and believing in Yah. If only the people of the
world. Stop. I want to be clear. We're using Yah there because that's who it's speaking of. Literally, when you read this verse, he's definitely talking about Yah, and I'm going to show you why.
Continue.
If only the people of the book.
If only the people of the book. Now, the people of the book, according to the Quran, is Israel. The book is the Tanakh and Torah, according to the Quran. That's the book. Hear what I'm saying? What he said is, if only Ishmael, you took it on. If only Israel would, the world would be saved. That's what he's saying.
If only the people of the book had faith.
If they only had faith, if they wasn't afraid, if they wasn't scared to be who they're supposed to be,
it were best for them.
It would be best for them. Go ahead.
Among them are some who have faith.
Among them are some who have faith.
But
who's not afraid to stand and tell the truth. Who's not afraid to walk in this light. Who's not afraid to lose their families fighting for that which is 100% right, which is your Elohim.
But most of them are perverted transgressors.
And that's true. He just brought that out. The majority of our people, the majority of Israel is on the street doing whatever they want. But there are those. Let's look at that realistically. In the scriptures. How many years was it from Yahshua to Solomon? Because the kingdom didn't become great till Solomon. Saul built portion of the kingdom. King David built the portion of the kingdom. Solomon brought it to its greatest height that we've ever taken it to. And failed. What I'm saying is, you're at that initial stage of building the kingdom of yours. What you all have done with the legal portion is so powerful. When the timing is right, when that moment comes, and we have mastered, if when you mastered exactly what you're supposed to know, our nation stands on that foundation. You understand what I'm saying? On a physical aspect, I'm saying. It stands. All the problems, all the issues, the fighting, this and that, we're going to have those still, but not on the level that we have them today. Because that initial sovereign peace is what it takes in order for you to solidify your nation within the realm of other nations. Like I said, there has to be the spiritual component and a physical component to everything. It's not poof and magic, it's work. It takes planning. All of those things. Continue.
And the kingdom shall not be left to other people.
Okay, I'm going to end and stop there. Now, what is our philosophy? What do we believe? It's important to understand this. We believe in simply doing right.
That's right. Being righteous.
We are not a religion. We utilize that. We understand the power to define, and we understand utilizing that to be able to utilize that in law. But I'm coming outside of that right now. I'm talking about literally. We never have been a religion. One thing that you understand that's so powerful is that the actual scriptures are utilized in their law. You can utilize that as the supreme law. It's the supreme law. But what I want you to get is the Bible, or not, I would say the Torah and Tanakh, they are not, especially the Torah, they are not religious books. Religion was created so he could create other platforms to compete with you to take us out of nationality. You don't say an Israelite and an Ishmaelite and a Adamite and a Frenchman and that. You don't say that. What people say is an Israelite versus the Christians versus the Muslims. Those are religions. We fell into the realm of religion. Oh. Moors pulled you out of that. That's what you were saying earlier. That's why you said we do everything on as Moors when we're dealing with politics. Because that took us out of a religious thought and put us into a nationalistic thought. Israel is a nation of people, not a religion. The scriptures is a, this is a, our constitution with case law. It has regular statutory law, legislative law. It's not a religion. So when you come in, so now with that power that you all have and thinking that, don't go in there. They know it's not a religion. Don't go into those courts with the mindset this is a religious book. It's not. These are codified statutes of law that must be respected by all people on earth. Not just, and they know this, but as long as Israel stays down and does not take hold of their Elohimship or El power, they are allowed to be on top and not tell you. You must understand your power. Go to Isaiah 49. Start at the first one.
Reading from the book of Isaiah, chapter 49, verse 1. Listen, O house, unto me, and hearken, ye people, from far. For y'all have called me from the womb, from the bowels of my mother, hath he made mention of my name. And he shall, and he hath made my mouth like a sharp sword. In the shadow of his hand has he hid me.
Wow.
And made me a polished shaft.
He made me a polished shaft. He's polishing you right now. What you're learning right now is so important.
In his quiver has he healed me and said unto me, thou art my servant, O Israel.
Thou art my servant, O Israel. For what?
In whom I will be glorified.
In whom I will be glorified. Go ahead.
Then I said, I have labored in vain.
Every work that I'm doing has been laboring in vain. I've been going out to work to make money for my wife. I've been doing this. I've been getting a car, house. All my work is in vain.
Go ahead.
I have spent my strength for nothing.
I've spent my strength for nothing.
In vain.
In vain.
Yet surely my judgment is with y'all.
Yet surely my judgment is with y'all.
And my work with y'all. And my work with my Yah.
With my Elohim. I want that word there this time. And my work with my Elohim.
Oh, man. Oh, right. So good.
My work is with my Elohim. The Yahweh. Who are you being? Continue.
And now, saith Yah, that formed me from the womb.
And now, saith Yah, that formed me.
To be his servant, to bring Yaakov again to him.
To bring Yaakov back to him again. But watch this.
Though Israel be not gathered, yet shall I be glory in the eyes of Yah. And my Yah shall be my strength. And he said, it is a light thing that thou shalt be my servant to raise up the tribes of Jacob, and to restore the preserved of Israel. I will also give thee for a light to the Gentile.
Now the word Gentiles there is nations. I'm going to give you a light as a light to the nations. So I don't care what nationality you are. When Israel comes, you must listen when the right ones come. Sir, go to the Quran. when the right ones come.
Well, that's what we got like that.
It's very important. Started on the 10th of August.
Reading from the Holy Quran.
Okay.
Say that again. Reading from what?
Reading from the Holy Quran.
Go ahead.
Surah 3, Ayat 110. Ye are the best of people, evolved for mankind, enjoining what is right, forbidding what is wrong, and believing in Yah. If only the people of the
world. I want to be clear. We're using Yah there because that's who it's speaking of. Literally, when you read this verse, he's definitely talking about Yah, and I'm going to show you why.
If only the people of the book.
If only the people of the book. Now, the people of the book, according to the Quran, is Israel. The book is the Tanakh and Torah, according to the Quran. That's the book. Hear what I'm saying? What he said is, if only Ishmael, you took it on. If only Israel would, the world would be saved. That's what he's saying.
Continue.
If only the people of the book had faith.
If they only had faith, if they wasn't afraid, if they wasn't scared to be who they're supposed to be,
it were best for them.
It would be best for them. Go ahead.
Among them are some who have faith.
But who's not afraid to stand and tell the truth, who's not afraid to walk in this light, who's not afraid to lose their families fighting for that which is 100% right, which is your Elohim.
Continue.
But most of them are perverted transgressors.
And that's true. He just brought that out. The majority of our people, the majority of Israel is on the street doing whatever they want. But there are those we developed and declared. See, when they wrote the, and you all know this, they did not ask or beg the Constitution. They didn't go to England and say, hey, we want a Constitution. Is that okay with you? No. They declared. They declared their independence. That's the same thing with the kingdom. We declare, you have 400 strong men and women that declared their independence for the first time of our people in history to leave America, go into the land of Liberia, and then move back into the land of Israel as prophesied. How do you know a prophet according to your Deuteronomy 18, 15 verse? Start at 18 verse. Read the 18. 18.
Deuteronomy 18, chapter 18, verse 18. And it reads on this wise, I will raise them up a prophet from amongst them, like unto thee, and will put my words in his mouth, and he shall speak unto them all that I shall command him.
Exactly. Now, he spoke of the prophet Muhammad for his people. Israel also has prophets for the people that are called anointed. And as he said, the word Messiah is just anointed. All of our priests are messiahs. All of our prophets are messiahs. That's not a spooky term. It's not a term to look at, and that's another thing about the kingdom. We bring to take the spookiness out of everything. It's not a spooky term. It's a term designed just like any national position. It's a term anointed. Go ahead.
And it shall come to pass,
mm-hmm,
that whosoever will not hearken unto my words.
Whosoever shall not hearken unto my words, go ahead.
Which he shall speak,
mm-hmm,
in my name.
Okay.
I will require it of him.
I will require it of him. Go ahead.
But the prophet.
But the prophet that what?
which shall presume to speak a word in my name.
That shall presume to speak a word in my name.
Which I have not commanded him.
That I have not commanded him to speak. Hear very closely. Go ahead.
Or that shall speak in the name of other gods.
Go ahead. And stop. I want to stop here because I want to stop here because I want to make sure that we're clear here. When he says a prophet that speaks in other names, I want to say this, and I want to be clear. This is my opinion, and I've heard it from other leadership within the kingdom. Allah is not another God. So I don't want to take that and say that. Because when you read the Quran, they're talking about y'all. Allah just means the power, the God. But the name, as a matter of fact, in Israel, the Ishmaelites, they actually say Yah Allah. They say Yah Allah. We say Elohim, but could have been in the ancient Allahayim. Aleph Lamed Hey, same. Aleph Lamed Hey. Coming from the same root, Al, or El, which is your last name, which you held on to, power. Who are you being? So, when I'm reading this and saying that, I'm understanding because we didn't do our job as Israel, the rest of the world had to find their way back also. So, Mahmoud or Muhammad that came forth, his purpose, he was studying with the Israelites. He was going there to teach his people to walk back in the laws of Yah, which brought us back to what? Adam, back to Islam, which there is no trace for, because it's peace, which took us all the way back to Adam and before.
But the prophets which shall presume to speak a word in my name, which I have not commanded, but the prophet which shall presume to speak a word in my name, which I have not commanded him to speak, or that shall speak in the name of other gods, even that prophet shall die. And if thou shalt say in thy heart, how shall we know the word which Yah has not spoken?
How shall we know this? Go ahead.
When a prophet speaks in the name of Yah, if the thing follow not,
and don't come to pass,
nor come to pass, that is the thing which Yah have not spoken.
God hasn't said it.
But the prophet has spoken it presumptuously.
Right.
Thou shalt not be afraid of him.
You don't have to respect him. The prophet who says, so now let's go back to Benjamin. Because I'm going to deal with this because the establishment of the kingdom had to take place. And what happens is we get caught up in the storybook mentality. And so we cannot move into where we're supposed to be because we keep going back in our past, which keeps us locked there in our past. We got to continue moving. So what I'm going to look at is, in 1967, Ben-Ami stated that the angel, or 1966, look out, the angel Gabriel came to him in a dream and told him to take the children of Israel back to Israel. Now, how do we know that that's a truth? Because it happened. Let me tell you, we're there, exactly. Let me, for 50 years, let me tell you, at this time, the majority of people that went with him, they thought Israel was a place in the sky. They didn't even know that it was really a geographical location on earth. That was the mentality of the people at that time. They went into the land of Liberia and grew. And then we went into the land of Israel. Now, for you to come into the land of Israel, I don't know, in the 1960s, that's a miracle. When Martin Luther King was giving his speech, we as a people will make it to the promised land, we were going into the land of Israel. You got to understand what's going on during this period. You got to understand what's happening with our people at this time. So the kingdom of Yah is the establishment of Daniel, the second chapter, the 44th verse. Read that, Merasha.
And I'm not saying this to be boastful or prideful or anything of that nature.
The reason that I'm saying these things is because I'm going to show you our responsibility as Israel. We have a part to play in what you're doing, and you have a part to play in what we're doing.
Daniel chapter 2, verse 44, and it reads on this wise: "And in the days of these kings shall Yah of heaven set up a kingdom which shall never be destroyed."
This kingdom will never be destroyed. This kingdom will be set up during the time of these kings. Not after they're destroyed, but while these kings are still up and running and active, the kingdom of Yah would be growing on earth. Now, what's the difference between a visionary and a dreamer of dreams? A dreamer of dreams only dreams conclusions. A dreamer of dream only, so they wake up in the middle of the dream with the money, but they never have the plan on how to get to that portion. So the same thing is happening. When I ask this, let me ask y'all a question. What everybody knows what the kingdom of Yah will look like in its end time, right? But let me ask you a question. Benjamin asked me. He said, "What did you think the kingdom of Yah would look like in its beginning?" See, nobody thinks about that. What did he say it would look like? He said it would be a stone. Now, what does a stone feel like? It's rough, isn't it? How does it look? It's not beautiful. Is it? Right now, do you realize that you have an opportunity to be a pioneer in the kingdom of Yah on this earth? Hear what I'm saying. You got to hear me because it's important. You are one, you can be one of the founders of the kingdom of Yah on this earth.